taco?
Absolutely. Definitely this mahi-mahi. Swordfish, you can't always, I mean, fish is, you can't always get great fish most times. So mahi-mahi works well, striped bass works really well. Tuna actually works really well, you know, go all the way through. Any steak, any made kinds of steak around the grill, it's not
It might just fall apart.
But that would be great for
part by the
front. You know, you can fry it and do the same thing.
Thank you.
go with mahi mahi. Or whatever. He tells me why. He never leaves me astray.
The mahi is very similar to texture.
So yeah.
That's a little more oil content, but it's still very similar.
Plating process here, I'm all over the board. Sometimes things end up on top or on the side. So you get to get creative.
Don't get rolled up.
Yeah, and you get to do your own thing. Show your family and your guests, you know, exactly what you're looking for, what you want to do with it. I miss my sweet spot.
Yeah. Awesome, great. So you get your pan a little bit warm. start with littlenecks. Really important for washing. They're usually got some sand on them. And then when you transfer it to your chowder, you don't want that here. It's a lot of people look at it and think, oh, it's just cod. But cod has a place of being this amazing fish that's been around here forever. And I think it's really important to stick with things like that, to stick with classic products that classic ingredients that have been around here for a long time. For the finished product, we're going to be hand roasting a piece of cod and then putting it on top of the chowder. Just so you guys can taste it all, I'm going to cut up some chowder and throw it right in the chowder. Same flavors, same everything that's going on. It's just not super pretty.
Well, that's fine. Do a pan fry.
Yeah, I'm going to cook pan sand.
Then you stick like a couple chunks or whatever.
It's going to be one nice beautiful piece sitting right up on top. It's going to press through. It's going to have a nice crust on top. It's just a chowder with a little necks in there. And then the cod's right on top. We call it a pan chowder because you put it in a pan of water. It's not a big batch.
A lot of fans that have a lot of people on your podcast,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
chowder.
How's it called? Did you make long strips?
Sorry, I actually just chunked it up. It's going to pretty much end up falling apart. It's the chowder. Doing it this way. While that's in there, throw in a couple more fish ends.
Are you Owen with the heavy cream? You gotta remember how much stuff we got here too. We've got, ears pretty much full.
Oh, you're good with it.
Oh, okay. I thought you were trying to be healthy about it. My idea.
You want to put it in a little bit while it's still cooking. Otherwise it'll just be raw cream. It's not always the most delicious. This. Salt and pepper on the fish. You can, if you're want to move it along a little bit, you can kind of turn the pan, get some of the grease, and kind of baste the fish with it like you do in a turkey.
Actually, I actually got a cake as you know.
Sorry. Got ahead of ourselves.
A little bit.
Just to be that skilled flavor.
It's real stuff.
Grossmans believes in local supporting locals. That's what we're doing here today. We want to support the great restaurant. They try to support us, and in return, support the local better and a local restaurant here. So we appreciate your support. Word of mouth. Business over there, so we'll do our best to support them. Any other questions? Are we going to clean it up and answer your questions at the same time? If you get shot by more seafood, we'll
to find. I think, of course, all of this provided, available at Grossmans.
And we'll have a class coming up soon.
Very soon, yes. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes.
We're here, either way.
We're here,
yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.